In this tutorial, we will examine the Cybersecurity Framework Assessment Mode, which takes a risk-based approach to cybersecurity and allows the user to customize a question set based on the needs of their facility. It is based on the NIST Framework that includes a set of industry standards and best practices designed to help organizations manage their cybersecurity risks in a cost-effective way. For information on using the questions-based or standard requirements-based modes, see the video titled Assessment Mode. We start at the standard screen. Selecting the Cybersecurity Framework option changes the title bars of steps 2 and 3 to better describe their purpose. We click on step 2 to proceed. Here, we select the appropriate tier. Tiers describe the cybersecurity capability maturity of an organization. Maturity levels range from Tier 1 to Tier 4. The default is Tier 1 Partial, which is the lowest or least sophisticated level. They are applied to each of three areas of organizational maturity involving risk and communication processes. To help you determine the correct tiers, a wizard can be opened by clicking the Start button. Read through each description to select the one that best matches your organization's risk management and communication practices. The overall tier will be the lowest of the three. Now we move to step 3 to create a framework profile. A profile can be thought of as a map of the programs needed, planned, or already implemented to address cybersecurity, aligned with the core functions, categories, and subcategories described by NIST. Thus, a current profile might address only those standards and guidelines already being met. In other words, the yes answers. A target profile would set goals for added cybersecurity. This might be a list of all requirements and questions without regard to whether or not the organization is currently implementing them. The screen opens with a default profile. It includes all the requirements found in the framework document. The default profile is not editable. Let's create a copy of the default profile and customize it to our needs. Here you can rename the profile and add identifying information. The framework document identifies 5 core functions. They are available for selection using a drop-down menu. For this example, we will select Respond. The labels, categories, and descriptions are taken from the framework document. To see the requirements, click on the plus sign to expand a category. This text is also taken from the framework document. If checked, each requirement will appear in the CSET question screen. Since the framework is meant to be flexible, you have the option to create a new category. You may also add or remove requirements from the profile. Click the Add New Requirement button to create a new statement or question. If you have added questions for a different saved profile, click the Import button to reuse the questions with this profile. For this example, we will add a new question. The new question has been added to the list. Be sure that the checkbox is marked so the new question will be included in the assessment. To change something, click the Edit icon. To remove the question altogether, click the Delete icon. Let's save this profile. From here, you can delete profiles. You can make a copy of a profile to edit it while retaining the original. Clicking Export opens a new window to save the profile as a file that can be shared with another organization. As we've seen, clicking Edit allows you to modify a profile. Importing allows you to open a profile created and saved at an earlier time. Be sure to select the radio button for the desired profile, so it will be the basis for your question set. At the CSET question screen, we can see that the question we added is part of the assessment question set. The reference information we added is also available for viewing. The rest of the questions on this page are taken directly from the framework document. To help you better understand the context of each, a list of related questions is available. These are taken from the NIST standard, listed as an informative reference in the framework. Click the downward-facing arrow to open the list for each question. Click the arrow again to close the list. Now, simply answer the questions to proceed with the assessment. This concludes the tutorial on Cybersecurity Framework.